Hello, my dear beautiful girls and handsome boys. A very warm good evening to all of you. And how are you all doing? Just give me a second. So yes, good evening Priya, good evening Vaishnavi, good evening Rupali. This is a new name I'm seeing here. So Rupali, welcome on board. I'm fine, how are you Priya and Shubham? Very warm good evening to all of you. Okay, so how to begin with the class? So on your screen you can see that like today's goal is human health. So when health comes, the first thing which comes in my mind is health is wealth. And one good example of this, I'll tell you in the form of a story, and this story is nothing but it's my own story. Meanwhile, many people have joined. I can see Divyansh, Marnika, Heman, Joshna, Vishwas, then Rishabh and Priya. Okay, so this is my own story regarding health. When I was in standard 12th, so my board papers were scheduled in March. I was fine, right? Kuch hua hua nahi tha. But the day I wrote my first board paper, the first paper was English. I remember it was first English, after a day physics, just a day's gap, and then 2 days gap for bio. Okay, so my health started deteriorating. Kuch bhi padha nahi. Physics somehow I gave. Then after that, it was like further deteriorating, and at midnight I woke up my parents ki I can't bear the pain like that. So then we rushed to hospital. Uske baad fir many, so bahut sare test waste hue. So then it was like the operation needs to be done, blah blah blah, itta saline chad raha ye wo. And then the day of my exam came, bio exam. So I was almost on the verge of not giving the paper. Like we were going through that for past 2 days, dena hai nahi dena, and obviously I was very depressed. But then my principal called, okay, ki no allow, ask her to go, it's fine, we will see, nahi hoga to improvement exam de degi, phalana chilana, fine. So that was there, no? Actually my principal ma'am, she gave a big moral boost up other than my parents. So then I went, I wrote my paper again. Like my recovery was very slow, and further I was infected, or I was having viral fever also along with. Like I entered biology classroom to give my paper, so I had a separate classroom to write with my catheter in hand, in one hand, and with other hand I was writing the paper. And then further my recovery was slow for the coming papers also. But then obviously when my results came, it was not as expected as I wanted since day one of class 12th, but it was not too much deviating also. Like it was reduced, but fine, it was acceptable, which you can say. So with this I can say that, you know, I always recall, like had that not been there, that moment, pure saal sahi the, exam ke waqt I was like gone. So this should not happen with anyone. But now when I look back, it's kind of a good story to tell. But then the moment was really, depressing for me. But then fine, with God's grace, I got good marks, so no issues in that. So there are two things to learn. First, take very good care of yourself so that these things should not happen to you at the time of examination. Second, you should be prepared enough and don't keep anything for exam time. Okay, exam time mein kya karna hai, just take your book, revise things, so that even if you do not have the time of revision, don't think that I didn't read that. Okay, if whether it's a your board paper or it is your entrance exam paper, okay, or it's a NEET paper, fine. So that you should keep in mind. So prepare yourself in that way and never remain awake too much before the examination night. Okay, so on this note, let's start the class. So please don't forget, health is wealth. Oh, thank you all of you. But and I want, if you people say that I am strong, I want you people to be equally strong. Okay, on this note, let's start the class. So we have on your screen, we have the recap of the previous class. So what we discussed in the previous class are the two things, basically Hardy-Weinberg principle and origin of man. And from that, the question, okay, this is the question which we were discussing in the class, okay. So here something went wrong. Itna to humne kar liya tha, but remember I did something like frequency of heterozygous. So this was the question which I was solving that day out of 200, 150, 50. So itna to samjha diya tha maine ki Q square will be this 0.25 and then we get the Q value by taking a root of that. So that is 0.5. But then I remember for this frequency I wrote 2PQ and 2 into 0.25 and 0.25. So, I remember Takshaini, Hemant and Deepa gave the answer also 0.125. But what is wrong in this step? It should come 0.5 because when we took out with this formula P square plus 2PQ plus Q square, it should be 1. So, when we followed this was 0.25, this was 0.25. So, 2PQ should come 0.5. But in this we got 0.125. So, what's wrong here? Hello Indrajit. And good evening to Tamanna as well. So what's wrong here exactly? Anyone can figure out? See here, what mistake was there is this value. This is not P value. This is not P value. This is P square value or Q square value. Theek hai? So in 2PQ, the thing was we put 0.25 and 0.25. Very good evening Mohan, we are discussing your favorite topic which you asked us me to discuss, but we are discussing the same old question. So this was the thing where it is wrong, okay. So it should be 0.5 and 0.5. Now you will get the answer as 0.5. ठीक है, so that is how we go for P square Q square, that's it, that was the point, okay. Mohan, what are you typing? Dug 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 dug. Shubham, if you are sleeping just for 8 hours, 6 hours, it has to be sound sleep, but yes, like advisable it is 8 hours, okay. Whether you divide it into 2-3 different segments, but it should be 8 hours of sound sleep, okay. So now on your screen is the question from CPP where most of you have gone wrong, and the question was angiosperms might have originated from A chlorophyte ancestors, B tracheophyte ancestors, C rhynia type plants, D psilophyton, okay. Then answer should be D psilophyton. Remember I showed you that chart where you had the successive things and from psilophyton only you have branching which goes to angiosperm. So that is psilophyton, and I remember I discussed that question will be asked in this way, from where it is originated, from where it is not originated, like that, okay. So no need to be sorry dear, it's fine, it happens. You are there, I don't know which keyboard you are using, what in our studio we have everything new and everything of the best qualities, but still somewhere something goes wrong. At the end of the day it's technology, okay, so anything can happen, so no need to be sorry, it's fine. Now on your screen is the goals for today's class. So we are going to start a new chapter, that is health and diseases. So we are going to start off with that, and then we'll be discussing the different types of diseases and some common diseases, just a few, because diseases discussion will be in the tomorrow's class, okay. And the diseases which we will be discussing, it will be very specific, only a few, not all. Like when we talk about bacterial or viral, there are so many diseases, okay. So we are not going into in detail of all these diseases, okay. Now on your screen is the definition of health, theek hai. So health, as it says, health is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being is called health, or the state of complete physical, mental and social well-being. Yes, Rishabh, that only. So what exactly that mean? See, healthy person, how do we define it? Healthy person doesn't mean just disease free. Okay, as of now I am sitting with no disease apparent, no symptoms or signs, so I do not have any disease as of now. Okay, but I go out and I start yelling at someone, or I am depressed with something, or mentally I am thinking about something else, so I may say the same thing. Okay, like for example, in the morning I was talking with your maths teacher Vandana ma'am, and then instead of naming the file as health and diseases bio, I named it as health and diseases maths. So I was lost somewhere, but that is just a small example. So that is called when you are not in your proper state of mind. That was just for that moment, so don't think I am not in proper mental state. Okay, so that is something which we cannot call that he is disease free. Then you know, say, you say, no, so there's something wrong with this man. If someone is walking differently or speaking differently, so that is the mental state. Okay, then how you behave with other people in your neighbors, society mein aapka kaisa behavior hai, or when you meet some stranger or in public places, how do you behave? That also shows your social fitness, how fit you are. And together all three, if they are perfect, then you will be called as a healthy person. Okay, yes, disease means we are not at ease, we are at standard ease. Is that so, Takshayini? Not at ease. So what we are standing at, attention motion, attention and standard ease. That's what there in our morning prayer, no, assembly. So that is disease. Now how do we say, like, you know, a person, this is the symptom and this is that's the sign. So what's the difference between symptom and sign? Because with diseases, these two things come very often, symptoms and signs. So what are these two? Are they different or they are the same thing? Correct. Mentally strong makes you more healthy. That's very good statement, Joshna. See, symptoms are the things which says yes, you are diseased. But what kind of disease? Say for example, you are having headache followed by fever also. Okay, but these are very generic things. Fever is there in almost every disease. Okay, it's very generic. And actually, when we will talk about immune system, that's actually an immune response of our body that increase the temperature so that the pathogen gets killed. So that, so symptoms is are very generic, which says that you are not fit. Okay, yes, correct, Tamanna and Radhika, these are two different things. So symptom says there is some disease, but what is that? It doesn't say anything. But depending on your symptoms, the doctors prescribe some tests. Okay, or they will look for some signs. Like for measles, you need not to perform a test or something. The red rashes are the evidence of that. So obviously that's the sign for the disease. Okay, or for chicken pox, that's a transparent fluid filled blisters. So that is, those are the signs. Signs confirm what is the disease. So that's the difference between symptom and sign. Symptoms say you are diseased, but signs let the doctors or medical practitioner to come to a conclusion. No, okay, this is the disease. Okay, yes, that can also be there, Takshayini. So health can be affected by genetic disorders, infections. So here we are talking about mostly the disease part of it. Okay, so it can be a genetic disorder, it can be infections from microbes, or it can be due to lifestyle. So genetic disorders, a number of genetic disorders you have been studying in genetic variation under post-Mendelian genetics, no? Aneuploids, chromosomal aberration. Then infection, no, I was looking at some comment in the box, okay. So infection from microbes or other organisms. So that is kind of acquired. And these organisms which are infecting you, that will be called as pathogens. ठीक है? And then it can be lifestyle based also, like food, water, exercise. Like if you do not take much of rest, as a result, you may be under stress. That will lead to hypertension or high blood pressure. ठीक है? So that is due to lifestyle. Fine. Like earlier, the kind of lifestyle we had, it was something where we had more of physical work. Okay, but now the lifestyle we have, it is more of sitting job. Okay, like after your schools and all, once you are into your college or when you are into your job, it's mostly a sitting job. Okay, so in that case, your body is doing very less. So obviously, there will be like problems as some pain or stress, or you know, when you look for long in the system. I think I have discussed this. You may get the spondylosis also. So these are lifestyle based disorders. ठीक है? Now there is something called disease agents. Okay, so these agents can be biological or they can be nutrient or they can be chemical. Okay, or they can be physical agents also, physical, mechanical. Or it can be genetic also. Okay, so see, biological means through some pathogen, this one, infection by some microbes, so that is pathogenic. Then nutrient, if it is due to deficiency or over eating of some particular nutrient, like carbohydrate, protein, okay, you know the components of food, so that is the agent will be there. Like agents are basically the cause, what is causing the disease. Then you can have chemicals. So chemicals can be endogenous or they can be exogenous. So if it is endogenous, so chemicals of your own body, like hormone production, hypo or hyper production. Exogenous, chemicals from outside. Like today we have lot of pollution and also that is causing lot of skin irritation. Yes, mosquito is vector and plasmodium is pathogen. Vector kahan se aaya Rishabh abhi? And then physical, we have physical changes like temperature, pressure. No, when there are seasonal changes. So basically, that is change in temperature or humidity. So during that time, you will find people fall sick more often. Okay, or simply even if you are in chilling condition, that will lead to some impairment or some kind of a disease. So that is physical changes. Mechanical can be due to extreme friction or pressure, like injury of sprain. Okay, so that is mechanical. So these are the things through which it is caused. And now these diseases are broadly classified into two things or two types, that is congenital and acquired. When I say congenital, congenital means the diseases which are there in an individual by birth. ठीक है? वो disease जो किसी भी individual में बचपन से ही है, that is called congenital disease. Acquired, recall Lamarckism. He said acquired diseases are the diseases, Lamarck said about acquired characters. Acquired diseases are the diseases which you or a person is affected during its lifetime, not by birth. ठीक है? It can be communicable, it can be infectious, anything. It will be acquired if it is after birth. If it is by birth or before birth, that is called congenital disorders. Now these congenital disorder can be anatomical or physiological, that is present by birth, and they may be, what can be the cause, a single gene mutation. Okay, single gene mutation or point mutations. Of examples are alkaptonuria, phenylketonuria, albinism, sickle cell anemia, hemophilia, color blindness. Okay, so these are the some single gene mutation. Like in case of alkaptonuria, there is an acid that is called homogentisic acid. Okay, that is in excess. by birth. So that's why when the person urinates or if it stands for some time, the urine will turn black due to the presence of that homogentisic acid. Okay, phenylketonuria is a condition where there is an excess of phenyl alanine, an amino acid, in the person by birth. So that is phenylketonuria. Albinism, it's white patches. Okay, sickle cell anemia, hemophilia, color blindness, all this you know. Okay, not necessarily congenital is always genetic. Like say for example, congenital can be environmental also, Rishabh. Like cleft palate. Cleft palate is when this upper lip is bifurcated and the roof of mouth, that is the palate, that is also bifurcated. So that is not completely genetic. It is environmental also. Environmental in terms of if the pregnant lady or the a lady who is expecting a child, what kind of food she is taking, what kind of a medicine, what kind of an environment she is exposed to. So those chemicals can affect the deformity or overall development of the child. So cleft palate is that, and hair lip is actually other name for that, and which is not advisable because this is comparing a human with the hair. Okay, yes, the reason is that, and because of that only Joshna, phenylalanine is increased in body. Okay, so that is correct, because of the lack of that enzyme. Then it can be chromosomal aberrations also, and that causes Down syndrome, Klinefelter syndrome, Turner syndromes. So you know the ploidy conditions in all these cases. Okay, so that can be, this is congenital diseases by birth. Okay, then we are into the acquired diseases. So most of the diseases which we see is acquired disease, and these diseases develop after birth, paida hone ke baad. And they are further divided into communicable and non-communicable. This is the two terminologies which we have been studying since childhood. Bachpan se padhte aa rahe hain. That is communicable and non-communicable. In another words, communicable is also infectious, and non-communicable is non-infectious. ठीक है? So communicable diseases or infectious diseases are the diseases which spreads from the infected person to a healthy person. Non-communicable diseases are, or non-infectious diseases are the one, the diseases which remains confined to a person who develops them. Like, मतलब patient के पास ही रह जाता है. He or she will not transfer it to a healthy person. That is non-communicable or non-infectious diseases. ठीक है? So now in case of infectious diseases, all these viral diseases, rickettsias, bacterial, fungal, protozoan, see like common cold, okay, or typhoid, that's bacterial. So all these are communicable, but non-communicable, there can be many reasons, and mostly non-communicable are non-pathogenic. Okay, so say for example, organic or degenerative diseases. So these diseases are due to malfunctioning of some of the important organ. That is why organic or degenerative. When some organ tissues, degeneration happens with aging. Okay, so wear and tear of the tissue, or any failure of any organ, like you say heart diseases, cardiac arrest. Okay, so failure of that, or epilepsy, that is differential pressure in the brain regions, so that will lead to that. So any deformity or any malfunctioning of Mohan, environmental factors are like, see, in congenital, environmental factors are the factors in which the fetus is developing, and that environment is mostly decided by the environment in which the mother or expecting mother is living in, and that environment will include the type of food she is eating, the type of water, the type of medicines, or like say for example, alcohol consumption during this maternity period, that leads to many kind of disorders or developmental disorders. ठीक है? So that's why it is always advisable that not to consume alcohol or not to go for any kind of addiction during at least the gestation period. ठीक है? So all these are environmental factors for a developing embryo. even like if mother gets a disease, okay, so that can also get transferred to the fetus, fine. Or it's like she is suffering, so its results can be seen in the fetus. The fetus may not be having the disease, but due to that, the overall development became faulty. So that is what we mean by environment. Okay. So now the next thing in non-communicable disease is, yes, very good, Kaya. UV rays exposure is an example to that. Deficiency diseases. The diseases are produced by deficiency of nutrients, minerals. किसी भी चीज का डेफिशिएंसी हो जाएगा, लाइक क्वाशियोर्क और मेरास्मस, पीपेम, प्रोटीन, एनर्जी, माल न्यूट्रिशन, बेरी बेरी इज अ डेफिशिएंसी डिसऑर्डर, गॉइटर, यू नो, डायबिटीज आर डेफिशिएंसी डिसऑर्डर्स, ओके, बट दैट आल्सो कम्स, लाइक डायबिटीज एंड गॉइटर आल्सो कम्स अंडर हार्मोनल, वेयर यू हैव हाइपो एंड हाइपर, लेस या ज्यादा सिक्रीशन ऑफ हार्मोन्स. देन यू हैव एलर्जीज. सो दीज आर कॉज्ड व्हेन द बॉडी व्हिच हैज बिकम हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी टू सम फॉरेन substances. So what exactly allergy is and how it causes, that is there under immune system, so that's why I'm not taking allergy in detail, but this is hypersensitivity of a person to certain chemicals. Like normally you, other persons may not be affected by that, but a person who is allergic will be affected by the allergen, so called. Okay, then cancer. This is due to uncontrolled growth of certain tissues in the body or uncontrolled cell growth, a cell which has lost its control over cell cycle, okay, or a cell which has become very notorious and is not ready to listen to its neighbors. So that is cancer, and cancer cannot be spread. See, my cells cannot say someone else's cells that, oh, you stop controlling your cell division. That has to be like in that person itself. So that's why cancer is non-communicable. Yes, exaggerated behavior sometimes means something else also, Tamanna. Okay, so now on your screen is the previous class contest question. The question was, name the common ancestor of the great apes and man. Okay, so the correct answer was Dryopithecus. And someone has also, some of you, only 3-4 answers were there. In that, there was Ramapithecus also. So please remember this, there, like you have some 1, 2, 3, 4 will come. Then you have something called Parapithecus. So this Parapithecus first diversion goes to monkeys, okay, the New World monkeys. And then in this only, then a branch is separating which goes to Dryopithecus. From Dryopithecus, we have gorilla, chimpanzees, orangutan, okay, the present day apes. And from here only another branch goes which says, now you have Ramapithecus, first Ramapithecus se Australopithecus, Homo habilis, Homo erectus sab jayega. And the winner for this contest was Takshayini. So a big round of applause for Takshayini, and may God bless you, because she answered Dryopithecus and Ramapithecus. So I can understand at many places it is written as Ramapithecus also, and somewhere I've also found it is written Australopithecus, but it is Dryopithecus from where all the branches of apes will come. Okay, so now on your screen we have the today's contest question, and you can start answering now. Marasmus, D, hemophilia. So which of the following is not an acquired disease? So I can see some of you have already answered, Divyansh, Shubham, Indrajit, and rest of you can still answer. Now the question will go off your screen on my count of 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so here are we. So we will start off discussing some of the questions. Just give me a second. see, here we have some bacterial diseases on your screen. That is only one disease which is there. But how do we decide that a particular pathogen is should be called a pathogen for that disease? Okay, so for that we have something called cautious postulates. Okay, so he gave four conditions based on which we can say that yes, a particular specific disease is caused by a particular pathogen. So first condition was that the suspected pathogen should be found in the diseased person, obviously, okay, and it should be absent in the healthy person. So the pathogen should be present in a infected person and it should be absent in a healthy person. Second thing was the isolated pathogen. Okay, how do we study the pathogens? We isolate it from the patient. So it should be grown on a pure culture medium with no contamination. Third thing, when this pathogen of pure culture is transferred into a healthy organism, it should cause that disease. Like, you know, Frederick Griffith, he used Streptococcus pneumoniae. Okay, so it caused death of the mice. So it should be able to create or cause the same disease in that particular organism. And now it should be recoverable from the infected animal. So these are the four criteria. If all these happen, so we can say, okay, yes, this specific disease is caused by this particular pathogen. Okay, so now on your screen is the first thing, that is typhoid, and it is caused by bacteria, that is Salmonella typhi. Okay, and the presence of this or a confirmatory test for this is Vidal test. This is just two words, but very important from your exam point of view. They keep repeating the questions, because now whatever disease we will be discussing, that will be in term of what causes that, if there is any specific test, or what is the sign and symptom of that. Okay, so that's how and how it spreads and how it can be cured. So that's how you should study a disease. Usse jyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Okay, so now, so typhoid, actually it is a fever. Okay, so we say it's a typhoid fever. So in that, the temperature of the body will increase, and it is really like the person feels that fever which comes, or the chills or shivering when it happens. After that, they will be like all the energy is gone. Okay, and the incubation period for this bacteria is somewhere around 1 to 3 weeks. Okay, so what is incubation period? Incubation period is the time taken by a pathogen from its first entry into the person till the appearance of the first symptom. Okay, so here instead of writing first, just write entry. So you have first symptom. This time which is there, this will be called as incubation period. Okay, so the time from infection or entry of the pathogen till the appearance of first symptom, that is called incubation period. Okay, and that may vary from pathogen to pathogen, and for Salmonella typhi it is somewhere around 1 to 3 weeks. Then it is present in the stool and urine of the infected person, and therefore it is carried by contaminated food and water. Okay, is carried by contaminated food and water, because see, the thing is like, you know, that's why we say that flies you should control, because they sit on anywhere, and then if they sit on your food, that will be contaminated. And then where it infects the intestine, and lesions on intestinal wall is seen. And what is the cure is antibiotics. So in later half of the chapter we will discuss what are antibiotics, how they work, and why on viral diseases antibiotics cannot work. Okay, okay, so there, okay, you too felt See, I pray that you should not be affected with typhoid fever. No one. Now, we have pneumonia, that is diplococcus pneumonia or streptococcus pneumonia is the causative organism. See, that is why, if you remember, I said Frederick Griffith used streptococcus pneumonia. But many many places in question, you may not find streptococcus, you will find diplococcus. So, actually, this is the old name of this pathogen only. Okay? That's why you get those options. Okay. Yes, thank you, Rishabh, for reminding me that typhoid Mary was actually a maid. Okay? She was a cook, basically, typhoid Mary. So, her original name is Mary Malone and she was a cook, but she was carrier of Salmonella typhi. So, carrier in humans are the ones which have the pathogen, but they will not show the symptom or sign. They will not infect them. Okay, somewhere at some point their immune system is strong enough to hold the pathogen. Okay, but they are potential enough to transmit the disease. So, typhoid Mary was a cook and she used to go and cook food for people, and for many years it remained like that, that his clients will fall sick because of typhoid, and nobody knew that she is the one, and that is why she also got a nickname called Typhoid Mary. Okay, she is the one who started spreading typhoid. That's that shiny. She must have got it from some patient. Okay, suppose koi bimar pada, she got it, but she never showed the symptoms. Theek hai, but then when it came to the because she remained carried. See, this can happen. It is not necessary that always if the pathogen is there inside you, you will show the sign and symptom, because at that point of your of time, your immune system can be very strong. Okay, and that is why you will find there are many kind of diseases which comes in old ages. Okay, and from nowhere else, nobody in your family will have that disease, but the person will have. Okay, why? Because that was there inside her. Oh, Rishabh, it's not always carried by human. Even males can spread this hemophilia, but they cannot be carrier. That is the sad part for them. But for women, they are strong enough to handle one affected chromosome, but boys cannot even handle that one chromosome. If you say like this, this is my answer. So, pneumonia, diplococcus pneumonia or streptococcus pneumonia, please don't take it on your heart. So, that is, or this can also be caused by Haemophilus influenzae. So, this causative pathogen name you should remember, and what exactly happens in this. In this case, accumulation of fluid takes place in alveoli and bronchioles. So, this is very important. Like in the next slide, we have the common cold. So, their infection is nasal passage, okay, and the respiratory tract, but not the lungs. But in case of pneumonia, it is the lungs, because alveoli is the sac like structure, a functional unit of lungs, you can say. So, alveoli and bronchioles to an extent. Ab dekho, lungs is the one which is helping in exchange of gases. Usi mein pani bhar do. So, from where the gaseous exchange will take place, and that's why the person faces difficulty in breathing. Okay, so now on your screen is how does it onset, or how, see, the thing is with pneumonia, it will not, like for common cold, theek hai, 24 ghante ke andar you will start having a running nose or something, but in this case onset starts usually with single shaking chills, thanda lagna shuru ho gaya seedhe, followed by fever, pain, breathing on the sides of, like pain when while you are breathing. Okay, so obviously your lungs are not fully functional, it is infected already, they are crying for help, and then you are asking them to work, that please exchange gases. So that's why you will have pain in that lungs. Okay, and then obviously this will happen, increased pulse and respiratory rate, because your lungs are not working efficiently, so it has to work more number of times so that it can fulfill your oxygen demand. Okay, enough of discussion. So henceforth, Rishabh will be very careful while commenting something like that. So now, transmission through, and what is the transmission? It is through droplets. Okay, so the person, if he sneezes, so that is the droplets which are there that will carry the pathogen, the so-called diplococcus pneumoniae, and then if you inhale that, you will be infected by that, and then by sharing the utensils. Okay, that is called fomite transmission, whether utensils or handkerchiefs used by the infected person. Then the next thing, okay Rishabh, it's fine, we got your emotions. Yes, lips and fingers will turn to bluish because of the lack of oxygen you are not getting, so you have more of that is in extreme cases of pneumonia that will happen. Okay, so now the next thing is plague, that is black death, and that is caused by this Yersinia pestis or Pasteurella pestis, and that is transmitted by bite of infected rat flea, Xenocyla hiopis. Okay, so that's a rat flea that sits on rats, and from there it takes and then transmits it to human being. Even in the year of 1994, it caused death of many people. Okay, so, and this is also known as black death, because in this case the nails and all become black in the person who is dead, okay, in the dead body. So that's why it is called black death. It's okay Rishabh, we got it, nobody is hurt, like you said something, people said something, okay, so nobody is hurting anyone, so just chill. Okay, and then diphtheria, so this is caused by Corynebacterium diphtheria. Okay, so I need to underline them because it's a scientific name. And what happens in this, a gray adherent false membrane over the upper respiratory tract or throat takes place. Okay, so that will cause the blockage of actually the respiration again, so this is again affecting the respiratory tract. Takshaini, the way you have written, we, yeah, in case of snake bite, people turn blue because of the venom and because the system comes to an arrest, so the cells are not getting the oxygen, so it turns blue. Okay, then we have some viral diseases, so that is caused by rhinovirus, and it infects the nose and upper respiratory tract. Rest, like its transmission and all, will remain the same like of pneumonia, but this is the very basic difference between pneumonia and common cold. In that case it was alveoli and bronchioles, in this case it is nose and upper respiratory passage, and that is why we have a running nose in this case. Okay, that's a very evident symptom for this. Then mumps, it is caused by paramyxovirus, and it is because of the inflammation of parotid glands. Okay, and MMR vaccine is nothing but mumps, measles and rubella vaccine, that is a triple vaccine or vaccine for three diseases which is given. Okay, yes Hemant, correct. Where were you Hemant so far? Like in the beginning I see you, saw your comment, and now only, so it's good to see that. And then again measles by rubellio virus or Polynosa morbillorum, that's the name of the virus. So in measles what happens, you get red rashes, and this generally affects the kids, okay, or the growing children of 1 to 6 years of age, they get this disease, and that's again viral. And for most of the viral diseases there is no prescribed antibiotic ki ha ye lo theek ho jayega, you have to give its own sweet time to complete its cycle or completes its reproduction, and then it will move out of your body. But yes, in some cases to prevent the effect or immense effect, you need to have some preventive measure. Okay, and why we do not have antibiotics for viral diseases, we will be discussing under antibiotics and vaccines ka section. Okay, so now with this we have come to an end of the class. So we have the summary of the class today, so what we discussed, is what are the diseases, generic thing, diseases, different types of diseases, what is infectious, non-infectious, and then we discuss some common diseases. And with this, I thank you all for joining with me tonight, and thank you all of you again for listening to me patiently for the past 45 minutes. And now it's CPP time, so you will get your 10 questions of CPP. Please do solve it. That's from this topic only, so that you can analyze yourself how far you have studied or how far you have to study again. On this note, I take your leave. Good night, Shubhratri, Shabba Khair, and do take very good care of yourself. Self, remember, health is wealth. Okay, so, and passport users, start solving the questions right away. Good luck.